called a funnel.
I'm gonna do this.
A funnel. What's happening? Because we emphasize STEM in preschool, my students are able to build on their confidence levels when mastering science, technology, engineering, and math. They're able to explore and observe different subjects, different materials, different tools, and be able to utilize those things sooner in life. I have a question.
What?
Is sand a solid or liquid?
A liquid.
Solid. Mmm.
At EduCare, we knew STEM was a yes for us because we wanted the kids to have some of that language and those experiences of STEM practices.
Let's look.
A few years ago, we received a grant opportunity to bring STEM to EduCare New Orleans for the four-year-olds, and we jumped on it. It began with teachers and supervisors going through an extensive training. We found that the kids loved it. It wasn't over their heads. It was very age appropriate. Several other classes now implement STEM in the classroom. So STEM happens in the classroom through play, actually through the centers.
At such a young age, they're at a stage where they want to see, they want to feel, they want to touch, they want to know what it is. Whatever they're playing with, basically finding a way to incorporate those science, technology, engineering, and math questions with blocks, sand and water, all of the different centers that we have in the classroom. You're gonna build your castle too? Adrian loves to build, and he's really thoughtful about where he's gonna put what. He was building a structure and it kept falling over. And he was like, you know what? I'm gonna move this structure over to the wall. Why do you need the wall? So that it won't fall down, okay. The bottom is called the foundation. So did you make sure your foundation was sturdy first? We gave them that vocabulary of foundation and stability and gravity. What's making that big, heavy, tall block stay on top of that little small block? So when you put the smaller pieces, Adrian. Come out, come get it, Adrian. What happened? It started to fall. Why do you think it started to fall?
We can't see building.
Because of this one? So this one made it what? Lighter or heavier?
Heavier.
Heavier. So you think you can't put heavy pieces on the edge or it's gonna fall?
No, up top.
All right, there you go. Also, we had Zoomy set up, and Zoomy's really fun.
Zoomy, because he zooms in and gets really close and lets us look at things really closely, okay? So, each of you will get a chance to use Zoomy.
We were introducing a digital microscope. We had different types of fruits, vegetables. Prior to my STEM training, I probably would have demonstrated for the kids how to use it. I would have used it for them and just let them watch.
So you can see all the little fibers and threads in the...
It can be engaging by allowing the kids to just play, stepping back, observing, encourage them to see how that tool was helpful to them just based on what they were doing as opposed to me doing it for them or me telling them what to do.
Prior to having STEM training, I was like, what is going to be the purpose of this? These children are going to be able to understand this. Here I am, a big grown lady, and I still can't understand certain science concepts. Once we mix the water in with the cornstarch, is it going to be a solid or is it going to be a liquid? It's really interesting to me that they're able to grasp whatever we give them. What about you, Kason? Kason, do you think it's going to be a solid or a liquid? When I was growing up, they didn't give us many opportunities to do hands-on activities when it came to science. I think if I would have had those opportunities that I'm giving my students, that I would have been able to understand it more and be more interested in it. So it's really fun to be able to explore those things with my students now.
No fish.